वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स. यस्टरडे वी वर रीडिंग चैप्टर इन द किंगडम ऑफ फूल्स एंड माय ऑफलाइन स्टूडेंट्स आर सो इंक्विजिटिव टू नो बेसिकली व्हाट हैपेंस आफ्टरवर्ड्स बिकॉज़ वी वर नॉट एबल टू रीड फुल चैप्टर. वी वर ऑन दैट दिस पेज पेज नंबर 22 दिस वन. So page number 22 we were reading. So what is that? So here the chain of, you can say, culprits were going on because one person was putting blame on another and another was putting blame on the next one. So it was just making a chain. So afterwards what happens basically? So when dancer was to be blamed, now the dancer was, now she has become an old woman. Okay. So when she was to be blamed, so she put a blame on the goldsmith. Why so? Because she said that she has given a order to goldsmith, okay, to make some jewelry, but she had to take rounds again and again because that person goldsmith was not providing her ornaments. Okay, so that's why this was the reason that she has to take so many rounds through that. So basically what happened, so after that he asked that king, when he listened about that plea from that dancer, so she was putting a blame on the goldsmith. So afterwards what happened, when blame was put on goldsmith, so they asked about that who has given order to that goldsmith. So who was that person? That person was merchant. So merchant was there. So they asked that they know the merchant or no. So they said yes, they knew that merchant. So goldsmith gave a name of a merchant, and that merchant was none other than, who was that? He was the original house, he was the original owner of the house whose wall had fallen. Now the justice had come in full circle. Now king was thinking about that merchant. Okay, it means now who was to be blamed, who was culprit. Basically it was decided by king that that merchant was to be called, he was to be blamed. So when he was rudely summoned back to the court, so summoned, what is the meaning of summoned? Summoned means to call, or you can say called. So when that person was called back to the court, so she that merchant was bitterly crying. So he said, it was not me, but who ordered the jewelry? It was my father. Father, he ordered the jewelry, and he is now no more, he is dead, and I am innocent because I am son of him. I haven't given that order of making ball because at that time he was a kid. So who has made that, who has got that ball made? It was merchant, and now merchant was no more, he was dead. So this was a chain. At last who was to be blamed? Merchant. And merchant father was, yes, order was given by merchant. Okay, but the king consulted his minister. Read from there. So Manshika, you come here and start reading from this page. But the king consulted his minister. But the king consulted. Okay, you start from this page number 23. Yes.
But the king be punished in his place. You have inherited everything from that criminal father of yours, his riches as well as his sin. I knew at once, even when I first set eyes on you, that you were at the root of this horrible crime. You must die. And he ordered a new stake to be made ready for the execution. As the servants sharpened the stake and got it ready for the final impaling of the criminal, it occurred to the minister that the rich merchant was somehow too thin to be properly executed on the stake. He appealed to the king's common sense, the king too worried about it. What shall we do? He said, when suddenly it struck him that all they needed to do was to find a man fat enough to fit the stake. The servants were immediately sent all over the town looking for a man who would fit the stake, and their eyes fell on the disciple who had fattened himself for months on banana and rice and wheat and tea.
Okay, sit down. Now, in this page, what is given? The full blame was put on that merchant by a goldsmith, okay, because he was the original owner of the house whose wall had fallen. Now, the justice was made that this merchant should be severely punished. But what happened basically, how they could give punishment to merchant? Because now the merchant was no more, he was dead now. Now, king consulted his minister and he took that decision with lots of wisdom. Okay, he said, okay, it is true that your father was a true murderer. Okay, he has done this murder, but he is dead. And now in place of that, somebody should be punished. Okay. It means whatever the property your father was having, his son has taken all the property. He has become the owner of all the property. So he has taken riches also, property also, all the things. So why not sins? It means if father has done whatever the sins, that should be taken by son. Okay. Yes, so punishment should be deserved by him. So after that, he made a new stake. So new stake was made for execution. It means new punishment rule was made. So what was that? Write down the meaning of stake. Write down the meaning of stake. A wooden post on which write down the meaning of a wooden post on which criminals are tied for being executed. On which criminals are tied for execution. So this is known as stake. So the new rule was made by king, okay, and he ordered this new stake, this wooden frame should be made, and this should be made ready for giving punishment. Execution means to give punishment. So as the servants were so busy in sharpening the stake, because it is wooden and they were just sharpening, making it sharp, and they were making it ready for final impaling and criminal. So this idea came into the mind of a minister that somehow that this rich merchant was somehow too thin to be properly executed on the stake. It means this merchant who should be given punishment on this stake, that person is very much thin, but this stake size is too much big. Okay, so it really appealed to kings, common sense. So king became so worried for this. Now they were thinking the stake that they have made, it will not fit into the, you can say, neck of that thin person, because merchant was so thin. So now they were taking a decision, what shall we do? So they thought now they should find out a fat man. That fat man should be fit to the stake. Okay, so the servants were sent, they were given order that they should go all over the town and they should find out that fat person who should fit into that stake. Okay, and their eyes fell. It means finally they found a person. What was that? That follower that came along with Guru, na, who took abundance of food and who fell ill. Yes, so that, because Guru left the place, Guru was telling na that this is a kingdom of fool, different kind of strange happenings could happen there, so it's better to leave the place. But at that time, follower, he was not listening to the teaching of Guru, he was not listening to the advice of Guru, and he was staying in that, he was enjoying different kinds of food, he ate up to his fill, he fell ill also, he became so fat. Okay, because he was eating too much. So in town, when he was enjoying food, roaming here and there, the servants were able to find that fat person and they thought that, yes, this is, its size is too fat and that person should be brought in front of the king. Clear? So when servants were immediately sent over the town to looking for a man who could fit the stake, and they were able to find out that disciple, that follower who became so fat after eating so much bananas, rice, wheat and ghee, because he was getting all the things at a very low price. Clear? Now next page, Dhiren, you start reading. What have I done wrong? Start from there. Yes, Dhiren, start.
Ma'am, before I want to ask a question. Ma'am, I want to ask that if the disciple, the fat disciple, also fit the stake, then how will it affect the execution of the merchant?
Because they were fools. They were not able to take right decisions. So that's why the name of the chapter is Kingdom of Fools. They made stake. They thought that fat person should fit in that. So that's why they started searching fat person, that fat person should be clearly punished. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
And the real culprit who was now free. So, because they have made a stake. That stake is, I have told you, it is a wooden post on which criminals are being executed. So when they made a stake, this frame was made. After that, they realized stake is made successfully, but the person to whom they are going to put, it was so thin. It was so thin. So that's why they ordered, they have found, you can say, they started searching for a fat person.
Yeah. May I start
reading?
What have I done wrong? I am innocent. I am a sannyasi. He cried, that may be true, but it is the royal decree that we should find a man fat enough to fit this stake. They said, and carried him to the palace, to the place of execution. He remembered his wise guru's word. This is a city of fools. You don't know what they will do you next. While he was waiting for death, he prayed to his guru in his heart, asking him to hear his cry wherever he was. The guru saw everything in a vision. He had magic powers. He could see far and he could see the future as he could see the present and the past. He arrived at once to save his disciple who had got himself into such a scrap through love of food. As soon as he arrived, he scolded the disciple and told him something in a whisper. Then he went to the king and addressed him. O wisest of king, who is greater, the guru or the disciple? Of course, the guru. No doubt about it. Why do you ask? Then put me to the stake first. Put the disciple to death after me. When the disciple heard this, he understood and began to clamor. Me first. You brought me here first. Put me dead first. Not him. The guru and the disciple now got into a fight about who should go first. The king was puzzled by this behavior. He asked the guru, why do you want to die? We choose him because we need a fat man for the stake. You shouldn't ask me such questions. Put me to death first, replied the guru. Why? There is some mystery here. As a wise man, you must make me understand. Will you promise me to put to death if I tell you? Asked the guru. The king gave him his solemn word. The guru took him aside out of the servant's earshot and whispered to him, do you know why we want to die right now? The two of us. We have been all over the world, but we've never found a city like this or king like you. That stake is the stake of God of justice. It's new. It has never had a criminal on it. Whoever dies on it, however, will be reborn as the king of the country. And whoever goes next will be the future minister of this country. We are sick of our aesthetic life. It would be nice to enjoy ourselves as king and minister for a while. Now keep your word, my lord, and put us to death. Me first, remember? The king was now thrown into deep thought. He didn't want to lose the kingdom to someone else in the next round of the life. He needed time, so he ordered the execution postponed to the next day and talked in secret with his minister. It's not right for us to give our over the kingdom to others in the next life. Let's go on the stake ourselves and we'll be reborn as a king and ministers again. Holy men do not tell lies, he said, and the minister agreed. So he told the executioners, we'll send the criminals tonight. When the first man comes to you, put him to death first. Then do same to the second man. Those are my orders. Don't make any mistake. That night, the king and his ministers went secretly to the prison, released the guru and disciple, disguised themselves as the two, and as arranged beforehand with loyal servants, were taken to the stake promptly executed.
Then what happened? Listen what happened. So when finally servants were able to find out a fat man, who was that fat man? The fat man they find was disciple. Okay, that fat person who used to eat, you can say lots, bananas, rice, wheat and ghee. Okay, now when that person was brought in front of a king, so he said that I am innocent, I am a sannyasi. Okay, he was just crying in front of a king and he said that what I have done, I haven't done any crime, I haven't done any wrong. So why you people are going to give me punishment? So they said, okay, that may be true, but there is we require a fat man who should be fit enough in this stake, okay? And they just carried that stake to a execution, to the place of execution. And when they were not listening and they were ready to give punishment to that fat person, okay? So he was just remembering the wise words of his guru. What were those words of his guru? That this city is a city of fools. And you don't know what will happen next. You don't know what steps will be taken, what action they will be taking, what decision will be they taking. So it's better that you just leave that place. Okay. So in his heart, he was praying to his guru and he was just praying that his guru should listen to his cries. Okay. Wherever he was. But guru, he was a spiritual personality. So he was able to, you can say, see with his vision that his disciple was in danger. It happens, na? When we pray to God, that please save us. And somehow we feel that our guru is our God is looking at us. It happens. So same like that, he was saying such kind of prayers. So there were powers in gurus. So he saw that yes, his disciple, his follower, he was in problem. Okay. So he was just praying to his guru in his heart, and he was just asking him to hear his cry. Okay. So in a vision, the guru was able to see all the things using his magical powers. Okay. And now he could also see the future. He could also see the present as well as the past. Okay. So he immediately arrived at that place. Okay. And now he wanted to save the life of his follower. Okay. So as soon as Guru reached there, he started scolding him. Okay. He told him. Now, am I audible to you? Am I audible to you now? बुला लो उसको वापस. Call her back. Yes. There was problem in that wire. So basically, I was explaining that there was a debate which was going between guru and disciple because they were ready to give punishment to that disciple because his size was too huge. He was of fat size. He became fat after consuming so much food. So when this decision was taken, so he was just praying to God. He was just calling the name of his guru because he wanted to be saved from there. So his guru listened all his prayer from in his vision, and he came on that place. Now he made a plan. They made a very false story. What was that false story? The story was that they made that this steak is to be fit only for fat person. And the story that they made that this steak is new one. And this steak is for the, you can say, God's justice. The person who will be executed first on that stake, that person will be the future king of this kingdom. And the second person who will be stake on that, will be getting execution of on that stake, that person will be the future minister. So when they came to know about this thing, they started whispering to each other, this king and minister. Okay, now they were absorbed in the deep thought, and they thought that they should not lose the kingdom to someone else for the next round of life. Okay, so they ordered that this execution should be postponed. Okay, and they thought that it is not a right decision to give our kingdom for others to the next life. Now let's stake ourselves on this because we will reborn. And I'll be becoming a king and you will be becoming a minister in the next birth. Okay. And they said that holy men, such kind of preachers, such kind of religious person, they never tell a lie. So the minister also agreed. So they told the executioners, okay, we will send the criminals tonight. The first man will come to you. You just put him dead first. Then the second man will come. And according to my order, you just put execution to the second person and don't make mistake in that. So it was a time of night. Okay. So the king and minister, they went there secretly to the prison. First of all, they released the guru and the disciple. Okay. And they disguised themselves. Disguised themselves means hidden themselves. So write down the meaning of this disguised. Disguised means they hid themselves, okay? Okay, and they came in front of royal servants and they were taken to stake place and they were executed there. They were being punished there, okay? So when the punishment was given and at last when they were given the execution and their bodies were taken down from that execution when they were put on that, when their bodies were taken down and their bodies were about to be thrown to crows and vultures, okay? So the people got panicked. They became so afraid because what did they see in front of them? They saw the dead bodies of king and minister and whole of the city was in confusion. So all of the whole night, they were just mourning, they were just weeping, wailing, and they were discussing about the future of the kingdom, that what will be the future of the kingdom, okay? Now suddenly they thought the sight of Guru and the disciple, and they thought that yes, because they people were being unnoticed in the town, okay? Now people, they wanted a king and a minister, so they all made a decision that this Guru and this disciple, they both should be made the king and the minister of the same kingdom. Okay, so this decision was taken and Guru also persuaded and minister also, that disciple also, you can say persuaded. So finally it was agreed that this kingdom of fools, now it should be ruled by one of the intelligent guru and his disciple. And all the old laws which were going in that area, that night should be considered day and day should be considered night, all those foolish rules were just now changed. And from now on, this night has become now day, and this day has become now become night. And now nothing could be purchased by using a dudu, by you can say that currency. So this place was becoming like that. So this was all about the chapter. We are running out of time. Only 2 minutes are left. So we will continue this chapter on Monday. We will be taking question answer. Okay. So this was all about that interesting chapter. Okay, students. Now thank you and have a nice day.